YouTube, it's Annabelle. I promised you that I would do her labor and delivery story, so that's what I decided to do right now. I actually wrote out her labor and delivery story to put in her scrapbook, so that way she could read it when she got older. So I'm just going to start reading what I have written for her. We arrived at the hospital on Tuesday, January 18th at 6:45 a.m. The nurse led us to the delivery room, and Mommy got changed into the hospital gown, and the nurse hooked up the contraction and heartbeat monitors. We filled out a stack of paperwork and answered a bunch of questions. Mommy's nurse for the morning came in and put in Mommy's IV. Mommy was already having contractions every 5 minutes and was dilated to a 2 to 3. Her doctor came in at 8:44 a.m. and broke Mommy's water. We were told to expect about an hour per centimeter of dilation and another hour of pushing, so we were expecting to have you around 10 p.m. that evening. The nurse then started Pitocin and fluids in Mommy's IV. This made the contraction stronger and stronger all morning, and we were still only dilated to a 3 each time the nurse and doctor checked Mommy. They had Mommy turning and rocking on a big ball to help move things along, but nothing seemed to help. It was in the afternoon that Mommy started feeling nauseous, and we finally got close to being dilated to a 4, so Mommy got her epidural around 2:30 p.m. After the epidural, Mommy felt a lot better. Mommy got some sleep, but there was still no progress at 6 o'clock that evening, when Daddy left to go get something to eat. While Daddy was gone, suddenly Mommy began to feel everything. There was a lot of pain, and it progressively got worse and worse. They checked Mommy again, and she was dilated to a 7 to an 8. Daddy returned at 6:30 p.m., surprised that things had moved so quickly since he was only gone for a half hour. The nurses started setting everything up for delivery while they tried to get the anesthesiologist to come give Mommy more pain medication through her epidural. The anesthesiologist finally got there and gave Mommy a big dose of medication and set up a pump so Mommy could self-medicate. The medication didn't work, however, so Mommy was still in increasingly amount of pain and discomfort. Mommy began to feel a lot of pressure and couldn't breathe, so the nurse checked Mommy again to see if there had been any progress. The nurse looked and said she was going to go call the doctor. She left the room and came back with another nurse who said that the doctor didn't want to have to wait, so they wanted to make sure he needed to be called. The nurse looked and said that it was, in fact, time to call the doctor. Mommy began to shake from adrenaline as they raised up the bed and got everything ready for the doctor's arrival. The nurse explained to Mommy how to push. Daddy got to see that your head was, in fact, right there, ready to come out. The doctor got there just in time to change. The doctor made a cut so you could come out easier. Mommy pushed through one contraction, and they said that you were coming on the next contraction. The next contraction seemed to take forever, but when it came, Mommy pushed as hard as she could, and out in the world you came, and screaming. The doctor had a hard time holding on to you. Daddy got to cut the cord and was smiling from ear to ear. They put you on Mommy's chest as they started wiping you down. You were the most beautiful sight in the world. The nurses took you to the warmer to get you even more cleaned up while the doctor stitched up Mommy. They weighed and measured you. Mommy finally got to hold you again, and the picture started. It wasn't long after that that everyone was called or texted to be informed of your arrival. Mommy and you got to bond while Mommy first learned how to breastfeed. The nurses took you to give you a bath, and Mommy got a shower. It seemed like forever before Daddy and Mommy got to see you again. From that point on, we would be a family of three. It was the greatest of days. And it makes me tear up. So she was born on January 18th, 2011 at 7:14 p.m. She was 7 pounds, 3 ounces, and she was 20 inches long. And that is my labor and delivery story. Thanks, guys. Bye.